Hi, I'm Rachael with Rasa, and today I'm going to talk about what you need to do to a Rasa assistant that you have running locally to prepare it to connect with an Alexa skill. So I have an assistant here that's already running. You can see I have a trained model. It's a binary, so I can't look at the contents in my IDE. And I've added two things to the skill to make it, two things to this assistant to allow it to connect with the Alexa skill. The first is this Alexa connector, and the other is this credentials.yaml file. So in the credentials.yaml file, I have a single line here. I'm not actually passing in any credentials. This is just defining the endpoint that I'm going to use. So the Alexa connector is the name of the file that has my connector. And then the other Alexa connector without the underscore is the name of the class of the input channel. So that's where that comes from. So what is in this Alexa connector? This is a custom connector. You can find more about how those work in the Rasa docs. But the business end of this is this SANIC blueprint that defines the endpoints and of our server that will be serving Rasa that'll be serving our Rasa assistant, and the behaviors. So we are required to have two endpoints. The first is this slash endpoint that just lets us know that we can send a little ping and know that our endpoint is live and our server is up and healthy. And the other is this webhook endpoint that takes post requests, so we can accept input. And the specific input that we're going to get is the JSON request from the Alexa bot once we tell it what endpoint to point to. And we'll do that in a later video in this series. So it's an asynchronous function. We're going to wait for something to happen. We're going to get at some point a request from Alexa, and the first thing that we're going to check for if the intent type that Alexa has detected is launch request. So is this the first request that the user has made to our assistant? If so, then we will say, hi, welcome to this Rasa powered Alexa skill. You can start by saying hi, and you could replace this with whatever you like. Just let your user know how to continue using your skill. If this is not the first request, then we will check to see if they have if Amazon has detected a stop intent. So this is a request to stop the skill. If it has, then we will stop the skill and say talk to you later. Otherwise, we are going to initialize an output channel. We are going to send the text of the user message to that output channel that will be connecting to our Rasa assistant, which will do the natural language understanding and the dialogue policy management and understand what the user's saying and figure out what to say next and send us back the thing to say next. So our responses we are going to extract from this data structure that we've gotten back from our Rasa assistant. And then we are going to say, hey, we do want to continue the session. We're not going to end our assistant skill quite yet. And then we're going to stick whatever the message is that we are sending back into this JSON file. And this is defined in the Alexa documents, which are linked here, and there should be backwards compatibility, so even if there are updates on the Alexa side of things, the skill should still work unless there's a really big big change. And this just gives it the correct structure to be correctly parsed and then said or written back to the user on the Alexa side of things. Once we have all the information we want to pass up neatly wrapped up in our JSON file, we return that, and that is what this class Alexa connector does. So for a single assistant, you could have multiple different connectors and multiple different files that handle different channels that are interacting with your bot. You could have multiple asynchronous requests, but this is the connector that we're going to be using for this Alexa project. In the next video, we're going to talk about how to set up your Alexa skill on the Alexa Developer Console in order to prepare it to send us all of the speech that the user has had transcribed so that we can do the actual assistant part of the task. All right, I will see you in that video.